So Claude just released Claude Code today, which is an agentic coding tool that uses Claude locally to manage files on your machine, actually interact with your code base locally in a terminal, which is pretty awesome. I want to show you how to use it with Cloudflare Workers. We have a lot of stuff that will be a really good fit for this, and we'll kind of walk through the documentation and piece things together as we work through it. So the first thing that we're going to do is install this new Anthropic AI Claude Code NPM package. So I'll start by doing that. It gets installed, and then what I'm going to do is just create a new Cloudflare project. So npm create Cloudflare at latest. And to give this a name here, I'll just call this my example Claude Code project. And I'll give it a framework starter here. I'll use the Hano framework and go ahead and install everything there. Now, I haven't done anything Claude specific here yet. We're going to create the project so that Claude actually has something to look through and kind of make determinations about what sort of things to edit. So I'll say yes for version control. And you know what? Let's go ahead and deploy it as well right now. And it'll log into my account and should deploy something. Probably like my example Claude code project.signalnerve.workers.dev. Instead of waiting for DNS to propagate, I'm just going to kill that process and we will go ahead and jump in. Okay, so let's start by actually running this Claude command. So first it's going to have me do some, oh, this is awesome. I am actually colorblind, so this is exactly the kind of thing that I would like. Okay, and after logging in, I'll just press enter to continue. There's some security notes here. Obviously, review Claude's responses and yeah, just some instructions. I'll say yes, I trust the stuff in this file. And I'll start by running slash init here. So there's this awesome command line tool with all of these different things going on to sort of interact with the code base. But to start, I'm just going to init. It's going to analyze my code base, which should be pretty fast right now, considering I literally just created it. It's going to start to make some assumptions about how the code base works. It's going to look at all these files. And while we have it do that, let's actually go and look inside of here at what sort of files there are. So we have this source file here, which or source folder, which has all of the files for the project, package JSON stuff in here, tsconfig, and then our wrangler.jsonc, which is the configuration for the Workers project. So it came up with all this stuff that we'll look at here in a sec. I'll say yes to creating claude.md. Let's actually open that up and take a look. So this is all of the information for this project that Claude was able to come up with during that init. Now, one thing I want to call out here is that we actually just made this system prompt for Cloudflare Workers projects. And so while this is very handy, you know, it tells me what kind of commands I can run, looks at code style and stuff like that. What I'm actually going to do is copy this and replace, maybe I'll do everything after that Claude MD. And I'm just going to replace the entire thing that's like 900 lines of code inside of that Claude MD so that it knows how to do all sorts of different things inside of this project. And what's great about this is it has stuff like Cloudflare integrations, which is this code block that says, here are all the different options that you have to, you know, to manage different things like data, to go and look at browser rendering if you need to go grab some page in a remote browser. There's all sorts of different options to understand how Wrangler.jsonc works. So examples of how to fill things in there, and that should give us everything we need to go ahead and get started. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to tell it to maybe start by adding a new API endpoint. That accepts a post request with a name and returns hello name. Now let's see what it does. It is clodding, which I think is a new verb. So it'll go ahead and add a new API endpoint. You can see, wow, that was really fast. It's going to do this post slash greet. Do you want to go ahead and make this edit? Sure, we'll say yes. So it's going to go ahead and add that. Pretty cool. Added a new post endpoint, and this is all automated. Let's go ahead and see what happens if I say, can you start a dev server for me? So it's going to go ahead and start that up. It's going to tell me the bash command that it's going to run, and I'll even say, don't ask again for npm run commands. We'll see what that does. Now there's a little bit of flickering going on here. I think this is probably because I'm running it inside of Zelig. probably just a me thing with my complicated terminal setup, but this is pretty cool. I don't know if it's actually running. I'll just press, yeah, something. Oh, you know what? It did work, but it kind of got caught in a loop here. That's okay. Why don't I just run this here locally and we can take a look at it ourselves? So I'll grab this URL here. And you can see it says Hello Hano by default, but I believe if I copy this URL here and say post with name equal to Christian, and this will be greet. No, I get internal server error. What did I do wrong here? Unexpected end of JSON input. Oh, because I need to send JSON. And there's my Hello Christian. So that's our first function here. Let's do something a little more interesting. Maybe we'll add workers AI. And we'll say and update the greet endpoint to use an AI model to greet the user. This is a bit more complicated. There's some things going on here. So first off, it needs to run this npm install. I'll say yes to that. So it went ahead and installed that. And what's interesting is you don't actually need this package anymore. So it's funny that it tried to do that, but we're still going to use this AI binding here that it's putting in. Let me actually shrink this just a little bit. Oh, that doesn't work. But I'm going to add that binding AI here, and we'll see what happens when it actually gets to the say yes to adding it in the types. We'll see what happens when it tries to actually add to index.ts if it tries to import that package because it doesn't actually need it. If I scroll up here, yeah, so it didn't actually even do it. Installed the package, but we don't need it, which is great. And instead, what it did is update this endpoint to run c.m.ai run, generate a friendly greeting, max tokens. All looks great. So let's go ahead and do that. And while that's done, while that's running, looks like it already restarted here, which is great. I think we're just ready to try it. So let's go ahead and say name Christian. And that's it. Yeah, that's my name. So maybe if I give it something funny like, let's see, Captain Jack Sparrow. Will it know that I'm a pirate and give me a pirate-based greeting? It did. It totally did. Ahoy, Captain Jack Sparrow. So that's really cool. And what's really interesting about this, you can see it actually tried to install this package, but there's a deprecation warning. So it may have kind of learned on the fly there, which is pretty cool. But not only did it, add code here, like this is kind of the easy mode, right? We know there's some code that has to be added. It was also able to go and install the binding somewhere else. It updated this configuration. It went and did all the other sort of ancillary stuff in order to support doing that. So this is super cool. The last thing we'll see if it can do is can you redeploy my application for me? And this is just an npm run deploy. So again, yeah, it was able to figure that out. And it'll go ahead and deploy. Everything updates there. And maybe as a final trick, I'll just say, can you open the URL in my browser? I think it would try and use the open command here. We'll see. Yeah, it did. We'll say yes. Hello, Hano. And I'll come back here to my XH, like curl-like command. And I will go directly to production with it. Hello. Captain Jack Sparrow. Yep, and that's great. So it shipped to production. It's able to deploy and open the URL directly from inside of the Claude interface. So this is super cool. I'm going to put a link to this prompting AI models system prompt, which you can drop in to Claude MD to help kind of make better decisions about how to work with Cloudflare Workers applications. And I'm really impressed with this Claude Code new feature. I think everyone will have a fun time playing with it. I'll start putting it in some of my beefier code bases and see what it's able to do. So thanks so much for watching, and let me know if you're using this or using our system prompt. Catch you in the next one.